top prosecutor calls for strict response to blackmailers of YouTuber Tzuyang. Prosecutor General Lee One-seok ordered strict countermeasures on Monday against the alleged cyber wreckers who blackmailed mukbang YouTuber Tzuyang. The Supreme Prosecutor's Office said Mr. Lee ordered the chief of the Suwon District Prosecutor's Office in charge of the case to strictly respond to the distribution of malicious content, threats, and extortion crimes committed by cyber wreckers who, for profit and commercial purposes, promote hatred and cause extreme defamation, and to confiscate their criminal proceeds. Cyber wreckers are YouTubers who specialize in the posting of videos targeting people in particular, most of them celebrities, while some turn out to be non-celebrities like infamous criminals, all for the purpose of gaining viewers and getting paid. Earlier on July 15th, the top prosecutor had ordered that a thorough investigation be held into the case besides protection for the victim and the confiscation of profit made through illegal means. On Friday, the Suwon District Court issued arrest warrants against Lee Joon-hee, better known by his YouTube channel name Gujae-yeok, and YouTuber John Guk-jin on charges of blackmail, threats, and extortion against Tzuyang. The two suspects are allegedly at fault for pocketing 55 million won, $39,700, from Tzuyang, whose legal name is Park Young-won, in February of last year in return for keeping her past related to her ex-boyfriend under wraps. An investigation into the case was opened by the prosecution following a complaint by Tzuyang on July 15th against three YouTubers and another anonymous blackmailer. The case came to the forefront on July 10th when a YouTube channel, Hoverlab, revealed a voice recording between Lee and John over the phone. In the exposition, he revealed to John that he had signed a contract with Park under which he agreed not to speak about her past related to her working at a hostess bar, something she was forced to do by her now-dead ex-boyfriend, in return for 55 million won. The next day, 27-year-old YouTuber Tzuyang, who has more than 10 million subscribers, disclosed on a live stream video that she was physically assaulted and threatened by her former boyfriend, who was the CEO of her agency, for 4 years. It was a criminal case against Park's ex-boyfriend, charged with sexual abuse, physical assault, and threats. The case was closed after he died by suicide during the investigation. There have been calls for legislative petitions regarding what is termed the cyberleka, foot-and-mouth disease, and national march. The move is to forestall cyber wreckers flaring up under investigation for blackmailing famous YouTuber Tzuyang. On the 28th, lawyers No Jong-eon and Lee Goon from Ong Ong, a law firm, announced that on the 22nd they had filed a petition to the National Assembly for public consent over the amendment to the Information and Communication Network Act, otherwise known as the Cyber Reckoning Prevention Act, regarding the confiscation of profits along with punitive damages for fake news spread by cyber reckoning. The petitioning system for public consent of the National Assembly is a system in which, in the case of petitioning by the people for legislation, the petition on legislation shall be submitted to the National Assembly's Legislative and Judiciary Committee as a bill if 50,000 people agree with it within 30 days. Lawyer No Jong-eon and Lee Goon said, "Cyber recursers collect enormous YouTube profits as pseudo-media while avoiding social responsibilities, neutrality, and fairness of media, or extorting money and valuables from victims under the pretext of broadcasting. Unfortunately, however, it is difficult to prevent with the current legal system," he said. In order to prevent cyber recursor damage, it can be an effective countermeasure only by fundamentally blocking the benefits of spreading fake news, as well as existing criminal penalties and alimony. It is time to legally consider an institution that uses all the profits, from channel profits to advertisement profits, and the profit of blackmail, which cyber wrecker received from mass production of fake news to recover the damages of the victims through punitive damages, or that the state seizes and collects all the above profits, he added. A lawyer, No Jong-eon, was the one who proposed the Save the Law to the National Assembly. Save the Law prevents the parents who have abandoned their parenting obligation from receiving the inheritance of their deceased children, on condition that a bill is proposed to the 21st National Assembly when the consent of 100,000 people obtains. The petition was abandoned, but it was not passed. However, with the Constitutional Court ruling in April that the legal portion of the legal reserve of inheritance system is unconstitutional, the passing possibility of the 22nd National Assembly has increased. Legislative petitions came out for the so-called cyberleka, foot-and-mouth disease, and national march being investigated for blackmailing famous YouTuber Tzuyang to prevent cyber wreckers from flare-up. On the 28th, Ongong Law Office attorneys No Jong-yeon and Lee Go-un revealed that on the 22nd, they had submitted to the National Assembly an application for public consent regarding legislation to revise the Information and Communication Network Act, formerly known as the Cyber Reckoning Prevention Act, relating to the confiscation of profits and punitive damages against the spread of fake news by cyber reckoning. The public petitioning system of the National Assembly is one whereby the legislative petition, when people are petitioning for legislation, shall be presented as a bill to the Legislative and Judiciary Committee of the National Assembly in case 50,000 people agree to it within 30 days. Lawyer No Jong-yeon and Lee Go-un explained, "Cyber recursers collect enormous YouTube profits very frequently as pseudo-media while avoiding social responsibilities, neutrality, and fairness of the media, or extorting money and valuables from victims under the pretext of broadcasting. And the current legal system unfortunately cannot prevent this," he said. "So, in order to prevent cyber recursor damage, it would be an effective countermeasure only by fundamentally blocking the benefits of spreading fake news, as well as existing criminal penalties and alimony. I think it is time to legally consider an institution that uses all profits, channeling profits, advertisement profits, profits from blackmail, which CyberWrecker got from the mass production of fake news to recover the damages of the victims through punitive damages, or the state confiscated and collected all the above profits," said Mr. Moon. And lawyer No Jong-yeon is the person who has proposed Save the Law to the National Assembly. Save the Law prevents parents who have abandoned their parenting obligations from receiving the inheritance of their deceased children. A petition was abandoned when a bill was proposed at the 21st National Assembly with the consent of 100,000 people, but was not passed. However, the possibility that the 22nd National Assembly could pass has gone up higher following the April decision by the Constitutional Court declaring the inheritance system's legal reserve is partially unconstitutional. Prosecutors raid YouTuber Gu Jae-yok's home in blackmail investigation. Prosecutors on Thursday raided the residence of a YouTuber, Gu Jae-yok, over allegations of coercion and blackmail against another popular YouTuber, Tzuyang. On the third day since the case was forwarded to Suwon District Prosecutors Office from Seoul Central District Prosecutors Office, it searched and seized Gu Jae-yok's residence in Jaeonggi. Gu Jae-yok is a woman whose real name is Lee Joon-hee. She is suspected of extorting 55 million won, $39,650, from Tzuyang, whose real name is Park Young-won, by threatening to reveal details about her past relationship with her former boyfriend. He denied the accusations online Thursday, saying he certainly did not threaten nor coerce Park and has not received a single penny that he would be ashamed of. Investigators of the prosecution also raided the residence of another YouTuber, John Gukjin. It was reportedly claimed by the prosecution service that John Gukjin had also threatened Park. Also reported is that in an official complaint filed by Park, John Gukjin was specified as one of the offenders. Monday saw John come out to admit that he had indeed received 3 million won from Lee. This, according to the warrant for search and seizure, is for suspects conspired to extort valuables by threatening to expose private life unless the victim pays money. Citing ample reason to believe that Lee and John had indeed engaged in activities consistent with these charges, the court ruled in favor. The three YouTubers, including Lee and John, were charged with asking money from Park in return for keeping silent over her controversial past. This case was brought to light after a livestream video where she confessed to the abuse of her ex-boyfriend and financial extortion on July 11th. It was an admission to another exposure made by another YouTube channel, Hoverlab Incorporated, which uploaded voice recordings of John and Lee discussing their plan to get money from her. The Korean Bar Association decided on Friday to directly investigate an accusation that Park's past information was leaked to Lee by an attorney representing her ex-boyfriend. The association said a third-party report requesting a probe into the attorney who defended Park's former boyfriend was registered on Thursday. In a YouTube video Thursday, Park said the previous day she found out a lawyer surnamed Choi, who had represented her previous agency's head, had revealed her private life, secrets, and false information. Park said she had been physically and verbally abused for 4 years by the head of her then agency, who was also her boyfriend at the time. In the video, Park's lawyer Kim Tae-yun said it is not acceptable that lawyer Choi ditched the ethical duty and used the information acquired from his client for a power play. According to Kim, an unidentified source sent them voice records between Gu Jae-yeok and lawyer Choi, who became privy to all information about Park's personal life and taxation records since Choi represented the head of Park's former agency.